Glasgow, a city that's synonymous with the Clyde and with shipbuilding, most recently the Type 26.
The Type 26 frigates are the most advanced, complex anti-submarine warfare frigates in the world.
But unfortunately, Glasgow is also synonymous with a certain kind of weather.
Rain, obviously.
One of the kind of biggest bottlenecks we had in our process was that we could only assemble one ship at a time at the hardstand outside our shipbuilding outfit hall in Govan. And that meant that we couldn't improve the drumbeats between the ships.
So the business case fundamentally started with, let's not build ships outside, let's build them inside, let's build more than one at a time, and let's avoid the lovely Glasgow weather as much as we possibly can, because that weather is disrupting the programme.
So we had to find a solution to that.
So one of the options that we looked at was to take the current shipbuild outfit hall and extend it back that way, back towards Govan Road. However, in the way of that is some of the oldest buildings on the site, and some of them are listed. And that was going to bring a fair amount of complication. It also meant that we would also be building a new building where the new ships are currently being built. And that's when the idea came up to build it on the water.
Using the wet basin, an unused dock that dated back to the 1850s, was an ingenious way of expanding the yard's footprint, while also avoiding disruption to ongoing shipbuilding work.
And we came up with some fantastic collaborative ideas. The building is really flexible.
Building a building is different to building ships. One of the fascinating things to observe is how our normal shipbuilding team have adapted with the help of McLaughlin Harvey to be building now an iconic building rather than ships on the Clyde.
Beginning in 2023, McLaughlin and Harvey and their subcontractors started laying the foundations for the assembly hall, making sure the reclaimed land was up to the eye-watering challenge ahead.
The reinforced concrete slabs really have to take a lot of weight. They're going to be under a lot of pressure. There's got not only just dead weight with the ships that are sitting there, but the live load, the transportation of the ships coming in. So, yeah, for us, a lot of pressure to make sure we're pouring the right concrete, we're hitting the programme, we're handing over obviously a good quality end product.
At the marine end, McLaughlin and Harvey civil engineers built the all-important North Quay. While to the west of the hull, there was also another critical activity, the construction of thousands of burgers.
In this picture here, we can see HMS Cardiff. So if you can imagine two of these within this assembly hall being built, so it's going to be a very busy place going forward.
Key to the assembly hall are two gantry cranes and two Goliaths.
I'll just start to travel 100 tonne now. The smart features we've got on these that we need to know about are the tandem function, we've got your sway control, we've got anti-collision.
The technology on these, they are as good as you will find out there.
You see it's connected because we're getting live data from the crane now.
We really are industry leaders in terms of this sector and others, these overhead gantry cranes and Goliath cranes. It really is cutting edge technology.
One of the objectives of the project was to build both the assembly hall and a Type 26 frigate simultaneously.
What was a critical thing for us was getting the build hall ready for Belfast going into it at the end of 2024. And achieving that was really fantastic for the teams.
It was a privilege in December to be inside the building as the first unit rolled in, working alongside McLaughlin Harvey that are still in their construction phases as we've entered into the building. Joint workings really enabled us to transition through this period and make sure we can jointly deliver both the building and our production continuously on our HMS Belfast.
As the assembly hall nears completion, the first footers are clearly impressed.
It doesn't do it justice, the drawing, eh?
It doesn't. You look at the height, complexity of the trusses, the size of the opening of the door, you look at the framing across the back.
Yeah, it's wild. I worked on this pre-construction for 2 years, so to see the project actually near enough complete is it's a good feeling.
You look at drawings, you look at models, but seeing it in person is amazing.
You walk around here, you get that cathedral effect where you start looking up and around, and it's just, it's unbelievable, you know, in terms of the achievements that have been made here, and just the size and the scale. Now, we are employed by BAE Systems to look after the quality aspect, but we work definitely hand in hand with McLaughlin Harvey here. What this demonstrates is the fact that, you know, Glasgow's at the cutting edge of shipbuilding here. I mean, there's not very many facilities like this around the world. This investment by BAE Systems is probably one of the biggest investments in the Upper Clyde for over 100 years. And we all know about its past, but this is certainly its future.
Having made extensive use of BAE's visualisation suite to fine-tune how the hull will be used, it's now a chance to check the progress in real life.
Every time I come in, something's changed though.
Yeah. I came in this morning and none of that was there.
I've been working off the visualisation suite for so long, so it actually feels very real being able to step in the physical building.
That's the vending areas. Be one of the stores on the ground floor, general tool stores.
Oh, we have toilets.
That's sad that we're that excited about toilets, isn't it? This will be your access point onto the ship via the MC gantry.
Locker rooms. Wow. 8 floors up. You really see how massive the building is from up here.
I know, it actually makes the ships look small, doesn't it? BAE Systems, we really know how to build ships. We're sort of the custodians of shipbuilding on the Clyde, but getting in those from that sort of external perspective, coming in with their expertise from a building infrastructure point, has been actually a real joy to work with.
It's essentially all about the people. So the end users, the people that are going to be working in here day in, day out, they're the most important part of this, and they're what will bring the whole building to life, really.
So what do they think the impact of the hull will be?
The opportunity to scale up the work we do here is a pretty rare opportunity, and it's not something that this industry sees a lot.
The LEV extraction systems look modern. It's really important for the type of work we do, obviously, and it's to stop the hazards of breathing in dust and fumes.
I'm excited for the guys to be able to move into a world-class facility and improve their working conditions.
And it'll also be better for the ships as well.
It's a good sign that better things are coming, and it means for us that there's always going to be more to do.
And anyone can just go into the lift and jump up to the boat.
But what to call such an inspiring new workplace? With so many of our buildings named after prominent men, our workforce had other ideas.
So we've named it after Janet Harvey, who was an inspiring female electrician that worked here during World War II.
Janet Harvey was one of many women who took up manufacturing roles during World War II to help keep production going. Despite facing prejudice from her male colleagues, Janet became an accomplished sparky, working in Harland & Wolff, then John Brown's. At 96, Janet's war effort was finally recognised when she was awarded an honorary doctorate from Glasgow Caledonian University. The hall taking her name will ensure her legacy, and the legacy of those who worked alongside her, is remembered for generations to come.
To be able to show people that for decades, women have worked alongside their male colleagues in these shipyards successfully was really important.
We will be able to build 250-metre ships undercover for the first time. That enables us to be much more efficient and productive. That sets us up for now to deliver our Type 26 commitments, but also sets us up for the future.
It's fantastic, it's amazing. It's really going to change how we build ships.
Being able to work in the Janet Harvey Hall, building ships for our Royal Navy and hopefully others in the future. Protecting our shores and many around the world is an absolute privilege for us all.
It's really going to create this sort of huge heritage piece within our company, and I've been part of that. I can say to my children and grandchildren, saying, I was part of building that. Hey.
This hall means that shipbuilding in Glasgow is here to stay.